friends, my name is Dinesh Navarashi. I'm from Annavara. So last class we discussed about a topic from 10th standard, that is refraction of light. In refraction of light, we already discussed about what is meant by refraction of light, what is meant by refractive index, and also we discussed about spherical lenses, types of spherical lenses, ray behavior in spherical lenses, image formation in spherical lenses. So this much it is covered so far in this classes. So let us move on to the next topic, that is sign convention in spherical lenses, also lens formula, magnification. So we have to discuss here. So already we know that in the mirror also we know that sign convention, also their mirror formula and magnification. So quite similar that one. So here also we have to learn all these things. Firstly, we have to know sign convention. So there are some changes are there compared to the mirror. So let us know all the cases of sign convention. Sign convention in spherical lenses. Sign convention in spherical lenses. Yes. So here we have to know the sign convention. So compared to the mirror, so here also the same thing, it is some same things are there and some changes things are there. Okay, so let us know all the things here. Firstly, so we already know that in the sign convention in mirrors, the object must be placed at the left of the mirror, left side of the mirror, such that the light from the object fall from the left hand side. Here also the same thing, we have to place the object in the left side of the lens such that the light from the object must fall from the left hand side. So we already know about some ray behaviors and some image formations. There we place the object at the left side only. Yes, so this is the first sign convention. So here it is, there is no any sign, there is not positive, there is not negative, there is no any. So but here we have to know the first thing, it is the object must be placed at the left side of the lens only. Yes, so let us take that one. Firstly, the object must be placed at the left side of the lens. Left side of the lens, such that the light from the object falls on the lens. From the left side. I'll take only it is a left side. Left side of the lens. Like that. Yes. So let us come to the second form. So here, in case of mirror, we have all the measurements are taken from the pole of the mirror. Here there is no any pole at all. So here we have the optic center. Here we have the optic center, so we have to measure all the measurements from the optic center only. So we have to start from the optic center. Here it is our origin. So here when we take a perpendicular line on this, it looks like a Cartesian plane. It looks like a Cartesian plane here. So here this point is the origin. So that means we have to take all the measurements from the origin. So here we have to take all the measurements from the optic center. So all the measurements, second one is, all the measurements are taken from the optic center. All the measurements are taken from the optic center. Then, so let us move on to the third sign convention. Here also that one is same here. So that is, here we have to take the measurement horizontally. So that means here the measurement taken in the direction of light, we are taking it as a positive, and opposite to the direction of light we have to take it as a negative. It's the same. There we wrote that one, that is right side of the origin and left side of the origin. So here also the measurements are taken right side of the origin, we have to take it as a positive, and the left side of the origin we have to take it as a negative. So let us take one small ray behavior here like that. So here I am taking the ray behavior like this. Yes. So this is the ray behavior. Just look at here. Here the light direction is in this direction. That means it is left to right. So in the right direction it is propagating. It is moving like that. That means the measurements taken right side of the origin, from the right side of the optic center or origin, we have taken it as a positive. Or so just look at here, in the right side it is a propagation of light, in the direction of light. So that's why we have to take in the direction of light, we have to take positive, and opposite to the direction of light, that means left side of the origin, so we have to take it as a negative. Likewise, so here there are some of the doubts are there. Here from this, here in this direction we can measure? No. Here we have to take the measurement from the optic center only. So in this direction only. Here it is. We have to measure this distance. So we have to measure from the optic center, not from the focus. Not from the focus, we can't measure like the distance. So from optic center only, you have to measure with the distance here. And so when we take the measurement from these two points, so we have to take the measurement from the optic center. It is against the direction of light and the left side of the origin, so that one we have to take it as a negative. And here, so it is in the right side of the origin or optic center, we have to take the measurement from the optic center, and it is in the direction of light, so in the direction of light we have to take the measurement, so that's why we have to take it as a positive. So these things we have to use in a problematic part, that is numericals based on spherical lenses. So let's take the third one, that is the measurements taken in the right side of the origin, in the right side of the origin instead of optic center, you can take optic center is positive, and those measurements taken left side of the optic center is negative. So you can understand from the both way, that is right side of the origin or optic center means it is in the direction of light, and left side of the origin or optic center means it is against the direction of light. We have to measure, but must and should we have to measure the distance from the optic center only. Okay, so let us take the fourth sign convention. So when we have an object here, when we have an object or image, when we have an object or image here, so here the object is perpendicular and above the principal axis. It is perpendicular and above the principal axis are taken positive. So already we know in the mirror, that is the object, the size of the object or height of the object measured perpendicular and above the principal axis is taken positive, and when the measurement are taken perpendicular and below the principal axis are taken negative. So we already know that in the spherical mirrors. Yes, so let us take that one, the fourth one. That is the measurement taken perpendicular and above the principal axis is positive. And second, for fifth one, so we have to take it separately. That is the measurement taken perpendicular and below the principal axis is negative. So here this length, that means for example 2 cm or 3 cm, it is plus 3 cm because it is perpendicular and above the principal axis. Yes. Here this distance is, so for example 1 cm, it is, we have to take it as minus 1 cm. So because it is perpendicular and below the principal axis, and when we measure this complete distance, so here just observe, it is left side of the optic center, and against the direction of light we have to take the measurement from the optic center to, for example, this point A. So here it is measured, we have to measure from the optic center only. So here we have to take the measurement against the direction of light and left side of the origin. So this distance, for example 5 cm, means we have to take it as minus 5 cm. And let us take here, so this distance, so this is in the direction of light. This measurement we have to take in the direction of light from the optic center to point F here. F. So that's why, so it is, we have to take measurement in the right side of the origin. So right side of the origin in the direction of light, so we have to take it as positive. That is, for example, I will take it as 4, means it is plus 4 cm. Yes. So it is very useful in the while solving numericals. Yes. So let us take the sixth final one, that is focal length. The focal length of convex lens is positive. So we already know that one. That is, it's a transparent material. There is no any reflection at all. But here, when we have a convex lens, so after passing through the convex lens, it must refract. The light must refract in the right side of the lens. So that's why the focal length must be positive only, because we have to take the measurement in the right side of the origin, and we have to take the measurement in the direction of light only. So that's why the focal length of convex lens is always positive, and the concave lens, when we take the concave lens, so in concave lens the lights after refraction diverges and appears to meet on the principal focus. So that means we are extending the line in the backward direction. So that's why, so it comes to the infinite number of rays after refraction, it comes to the same side of the object. That means it's a left side of the origin. So that's why we have to take the measurement from the optic center to focal length. So for example, here I am taking this small picture, you can view here.
So here, so when we have a refraction angle here, it's like this, and here, for example here. So that means here it is. So we have to measure from the optic center here. So this measurement, we have to take the measurement here. So from this to this, it is focus, and here it is against the direction of light and in the left side of the lens, left side of the origin. So likewise, we have to take the focal length of the concave lens is negative only. Yes. So this is the sixth sign convention, that is the focal length of convex lens is positive and that of concave lens is negative. So we have some of the sign conventions are there. So firstly, we have to place the object in the left side of the lens. Also, the measurements are taken from the optic center only. We have to take that one. And measurements are taken in the right side of the optic center is positive, and the left side of the optic center is negative. And then the measurement taken perpendicular to and above the principal axis is positive. The measurement taken perpendicular below the principal axis is negative. And the focal length of convex lens is positive, and that of concave lens is negative. But there are some of the differences there. That is, this is same for mirror also. This is changes in lens and mirror, and this is same as mirror. So here just I mentioned optic center. Okay, so that's why it is changing. And then perpendicular and above the principal axis is same. This is also same, and this is some differences. Okay, so here we have to take like this. Remember, when you have to write the sign convention in lens and mirror, so the question will be looking like same. Write the sign convention in mirror, write the sign convention in lens. The question will be looking like same, but remember, so which sign convention asked there? So that's why you have to aware of all the things, that is mirror, whether it is mirror or whether it is lens and how it is changes. So you have to aware of that one. So better to compare those two things, so then you can easily analyze those things here. Yes. So let us move on to the next topic, that is, I think already you know about what is meant by object distance and what is meant by image distance. So that means the distance from the optic center to object and distance from the optic center to image. So those are called object distance and image distance respectively. So we know that all the things, and what is meant by focal length, we already know that. This formula, lens formula or Wiener formula, is simply, it is a connection between object distance, image distance and focal length only. So when we have object distance and image distance, we can find out focal length. When we have a focal length and the object distance, we can find the image distance. So from the object distance and from the image distance and from the focal length, we can draw the diagram. So based on that ray behavior, and we can find out the height of the image and height of the object based on that. So there are many advantages are there in case of lens formula. So let us take the lens formula. It is completely a relationship between object distance, image distance and focal length. So it is a relationship between the formula. It is a relationship between object distance, image distance and focal length. So let us know about what is the Lenz formula here. It is 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by I. So that means here it is a Lenz formula. So we can find out the any parameter, it is object distance, event distance and focal length from this formula here. So what is the object distance here? Here U is the object distance. That is where U is object distance. U is object distance and V is image distance. Image distance and F is focal length. F is focal length. So here we have the Lenz formula to calculate any one of these parameters when we have other two parameters. So we can calculate all the other parameters here, all the other unknown parameters we can calculate. Yes, this is the Lenz formula. So another formula we have when we calculate, when we have the numericals based on this convex lens, spherical lenses, actually spherical lenses. So that one is the magnification. So also already we discussed in the mirrors also, that is there also we have a magnification. Like that here also we have the magnification. So let us take the magnification here. Magnification. Yes. So we already know that it's a ratio of image height to the object height. Image height by object height, we know that. So that one is same here also. That one is same here also. That is, it is the ratio of image height and object height. That is, it is represented by M. It is represented by M here. That is, M is equal to H dash by H. So where H dash is image height and H is object height. So H dash by H. It is also related with the object distance and the image distance. So when we have the object image distance and the object distance, so we can change the image the magnification as per the image distance and object distance. How can we connect it here? M is equal to H dash by H is equal to V by U here. So here, so this is the formula we can use in our numericals based on spherical lenses. So here it is M is equal to H dash by H is equal to V by U. So for example, when we have the magnification is 1. So for example, magnification is 1 or plus 1 I will take. Plus 1 means, so where, when it is possible. So that means, for example, sometimes in sign convention V is equal to negative and U is equal to positive. So when it is in the case plus 1 is not possible, because so here the object distance and image distance are different. And then, so when we have object image height and object height, so when we have magnification is plus 1 is, so the object height and image height must be same, and both are either in the above the principal axis or below the principal axis, then only that one, in that time only we have that case. It is,
so value spacing is one. When the size of an object, the height of an object, and height of an image, both are same, and both are located either above the principal axis or below the principal axis.
When we have the object distance by image distance, when we take that one, so both are in either in the right side of the origin or left side of the origin, and the both the distances are same. So for example, in one case, so we have that both the distances are same. That is, when the object is placed to a phone in case of lens. So that means the image is formed at 2f2 means, so when we have O2F1 and O2F2 are same, so then we can take those two measurements are same, the magnification is plus 1. So initially, here it is the size of an image and size of the object it is related with. So that's why we have to take the height of an object and height of the image is same. In which case it is height of the object and height of the image is same? When the object is placed at 2F1 only, in case of convex lens. When the object is placed on 2F1, the image we got is same as object. So that means there will be H dash is equal to H. But we have one object is at above the principal axis, but it is in image is at the below the principal axis. But there it is won't be, it is possible. There are some other cases are there. So there we have these cases here. So I hope you understood that one. So let us take one problem based on these factors. That is, sign convention we have to use, and lens formula we have to use, and magnification also we have to use here. Yes, here we have one problem. From the spherical lens. So which lens is used here? Concave lens. So better to write a small picture of that one, concave lens, because of analyzing the sign convention. How can we take that one? So if it is convex lens, you have to write convex lens. If it is concave lens, you have to write concave lens. So here I am just drawing in the rough part, that is, it's completely rough. After that you can erase that one. Yes. So for example, it's a completely rough here. Yes. So it's an optic center. So it is only for the purpose of writing the sign convention only. So because of memorizing or imagine. So that's all. Those who have imagination, so you can go through with the imagination. The object distance must be negative first. And those who are knowing the sign convention very well, you can go with that one. But those who are, it is difficult to analyzing the sign convention also, so imagination also, it is difficult to imagine that one, means you can draw a small rough diagram. Yes, so let us take that one. Yes, the concave lens is focal length 15 cm. Already we know that one, that is the focal length of convex lens, concave lens. Convex lens is positive and concave lens is negative. We already know that in the sign convention, the sixth sign convention, the focal length of convex lens is positive and the concave lens is negative. That is, here it is given f is equal to 15 cm. So we have to write f is equal to 15 cm, it is minus 15 cm. Already we know that one, that is, So when we have a sine ray diagram like this, so we have to extend it backwards. That's why here we have the focal length. Here we have the focal length here. So here it is, we measured from the optic center, means it is against the direction of light and it is left side of the origin. So that's why we have to take it as negative only. So here we have. Yes. So here the first part is over here. Then, so let us take the next part. That is, at what distance should the object placed from the lens be placed so that it forms an image at 10 cm from the lens. So that means here it is, we are using the concave lens here. So that means here just observe the image formed here. In all the cases, so just observe here, that means the after refraction, the light rays diverges from the principal axis. For that we have to produce backward. That ray we have to produce backward. So that's why all the images in case of concave lens is formed in the left side of the origin only. Already we know that the object also we have to place in the left side of the lens. Here the object is also formed in the left side of the lens. So the measurement is taken from in the left side of the lens or optic center, we have to take it as a negative. So that's why B is equal to minus 10 centimeters. That means here we have to measure the distance from the optic center against the direction of light. So that's why we have to take it as a negative. Then, so what we have to find out here, at what distance should the object is placed? That means we have to find the object distance and find the magnification. That means M is also we have to find out here. So yes, let us take the formula to find the object distance, that is lens formula. So from lens formula, so we have 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. So let us take all the measurements here. So that is 1 by U, that means minus 1 by 10 or 1 by minus 10 you can take, and minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F is equal to minus 15. Minus 15 we have. Then here we can transpose this 1 by minus 10 to the RHS. So that is minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by minus 15, and here minus of, after transposing it becomes minus of 1 by minus 10. That means minus into minus plus we have, that is plus 1 by 10. So I will repeat that one. Here it is minus 1 by 10 is there. After transposing minus of minus 1 by 10 it becomes, so that's why plus 1 by 10. Yes. So let us take, you can take the LCM here. So I will take LCM, 1 minus 1 by U is equal to, so what is the LCM here? 15 is there, 10 is there, I will take 30. And so here minus 15 is there, so that's why we have to multiply with minus, and here we have to take the minus 2, that is it is plus 30. So that's why here it is minus 15 is there, to have 30 plus 30, so we have to multiply with minus 2. Here also we have to multiply with minus 2, and here it is 10 is there, we have to multiply with 3, and here also we have to multiply with 3 plus 3 is equal to, then minus 1 by U is equal to 3 minus 2, 1 by 30. Then this implies inverted, that is minus U is equal to 30, this implies U is equal to 30 centimeter, minus 30 centimeter here. So we have minus 30 centimeter. So that means object must be placed at the left side of the lens. So that's why it is negative. Yes. So we have the object distance. So from the object distance we can calculate magnification also. So magnification. Magnification is given by is given by m is equal to h dash by h. There is no any information about the height of the object and height of the image. But we have image distance and object distance. From that we can calculate v by u. So what is the value of v here? Minus 10. And u is the minus 30 is equal to 1 by 3. Yes, we have 1 by 3 here. So just look at here, that is v by u is equal to 1 by 3. So that means u is equal to 3 times of v. That means here when we convert that, here u is equal to 3 into v means the here object distance is very large and the image distance is very small here. So and it is 3 times of image distance. So and when we take h dash by h is equal to v by u is equal to 1 by 3. So that means here. So only we take h dash by h is equal to 1 by 3. H dash by h is equal to 1 by 3 means h is equal to 3 into h dash. So that means here we have the object distance, so object height is bigger and image height is smaller and it is 3 times of image height. Object height is 3 times of image height, that's why so we can write the nature of the image, that is what is the nature of the image from this one. So here I will write what is the nature of the image. So here just observe, it's 3 times of image height means the image must be diminished. So diminished image is formed. Then what is the nature? So in nature we have the real and erect image. So here just observe, real and erect image means, so here in concave lenses we have to produce in the backward direction, so that's why it is always virtual. So this is how you take it as nature of image. Yes, so diminished image we already know that from this case, and virtual, so this is virtual, always virtual in case of concave lenses. And we already know that in concave lenses when we produce in the backward direction we have the image as erect only. So erect image is formed here. So in this case, so this is the ray diagram of nature of image, that is diminished image, virtual image and erect image. So that means this is the nature of image. From the nature of image we can draw the diagram also. Yes, so this is about the sign convention and lens formula and magnification. So these three are very important while we are solving the problems based on spherical lenses. So I hope you enjoyed this one. I hope you understood these things. Those who are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. So you can get the notification very easily. Also hit the like button. Thank you and all. Be safe and stay home. Thank you.